Good evening all, hope we are all doing well. Welcome along to Affinity Racing. I'm running a little bit late, but we're getting everything set up and all good to go. I think about 2 seconds before the stream realized I didn't have my phone plugged in and it was on about 2% and about to die, so we've got that plugged in. That's all good. Stream is there. I've literally got 3 pints of water beside me, which probably isn't a good idea for a 3-hour endurance race. Right, welcome along then. Hope everyone is doing well. Adam, how are we doing? Craig, how are we doing? If for a race that was his idea, he wouldn't be late. Exactly. Never. Just late to the stream, not to the actual race. But there we go. Hope everyone's doing well. We've got a good little turnout tonight, which is what we want to see. I think I want to aim for a podium, but whether or not we get one, who knows. I haven't done any practice because I had mostly my intentions of either being in the Porsche or the Supra, and then we all decided that we're going to run our actual championship cars. So I saw the message, I think it was John, that said, getting your championship car because everybody else is. So now I'm in the Merc and I'm literally going out for the first time in it on the racing mediums. We've got to use the medium tyres. We're doing a full 24-hour cycle, 3 hours at times 8 time, if that makes sense. So we're going to cover an entire 24 hours in this race, which is going to be really, really good fun. I'm going to push quite hard on this little bit warm-up and try and find myself the absolute limits of this Merc, because I've barely raced in it. Obviously, I've missed the first two championship races. Oh! There's the limits. I missed the first two championship races, so I haven't been in this thing at all yet, really. Jump out someone's way here. Do that. Good stuff. Yep, 7 p.m. start for qualifying. Anybody else behind me? No, all good. 7 p.m. start for quali. Oh, the understeer is not nice. And we're also starting with not too much fuel, probably about 5 or 6 laps worth, which is interesting. I'm just going to try and not necessarily take this flat, but push quite a bit. I do like the Merc. I just go, it always ends up being quite a while between drives in it. And John's trying out the wet tyres there for some reason. An interesting strategy. Wet tyres in the dry. He has set the lobby up though. And a huge thank you to John for that. Because that makes life much easier, right? And then just focus on the stream. Try not to cock that up. He has sorted out, done a tremendous job sorting out the lobby settings, all that, getting everything set up, prepped. But if he plans on going out on the wet tyres for qualifying, does he know something that we don't? It's on 7, Craig. But the John is running the lobby. DP's running the lobby. So you, if you're not friends with him, that might be why you can't find it. Are you planning on joining though, Craig? Be mega if you are. Just drop a message in the chat there. If you are, we'll hang fire and we make sure you get in. Third gear through there is absolutely sound.
Okay,
trying to on Scotty's account. Ah, right, okay, so I'm... yeah, so you'll have to add... you'll have to add John. You have to add DP. So let's try and sort that out. Yeah, there we are. James has dropped the details in there. Send a friend request to John. And we'll make sure we get you in the lobby before we start. Let me just drop a message to John as well so he sees it. So yeah, set up as friend. Yeah, set up as friends only. Yeah. Right. I'm trying not to drink too much. Evening, Bob, how are we doing? I hope we're all well. So I've noticed that the wind is actually quite strong as well, definitely having an impact. Friend request sent, good stuff. What is race strategy? Don't bin it, and I hope that you don't need the toilet within 3 hours. We do start with 30% fuel, so I think there's a chance, to be honest, depending on tyre wear, there's a chance that I might start on the mediums. As fast as you can without crashing. Yeah, mediums must be used though. We've got rain though, so we will at some point hopefully have to consider that and jump in to the pits. Tyres was quite low, relatively low. I think it was only times one or two, so fairly realistic. Then fuel, I'm not too sure on, to be honest. I need to jump back into the settings and have a check. I'm just dropping John a message on here. Thank you. Carlos has sent some good lap times though. Let's see who we're watching. We're learning from him at the moment. Oh, he's had a moment. Sorry, Carlos, that ended up on stream. Here we go, though. Lobby's being reset. I said we were going to double check what the tyre wear was because off the top of my head, I couldn't remember. Tyre wear 1, fuel was 2. That was it. There we go. So, fairly decent. Ticking. Sorry, it's me. Good to go. Mediums must be used for 2 laps. How does it... is that actually right? Or is it like minimum number of pit stops? Or something like that. Let's put the stream back on my phone so I can see what's going on. So I'm aiming for podium here on this one. But we've got some very quick people in, as always, and always some very, very good close racing. We've got 3 hours of Spa, which is guaranteed to mean a few mistakes. 11 in the lobby so far, good stuff. Oh, third gear there. If we've got Scotty joining as well, then even better. Although I don't fancy the idea of Scotty and Craig teaming up. That is a pretty good combo, driver combo. Let's not do that in quali. Here we go. We're about to begin. Absolutely. Best of luck to everyone. This is going to be absolutely mega. It's going to be a proper challenge, though. It's going to be good. back, yeah. Right, here we go, first flying lap. Let's see where we end up on this one. Oh no, is the stream going down? We can't be having that. Getting a few issues or error messages coming up on the stream. How are we doing? Is it all good or not? That was a slight moment, wasn't it? Just trying to have a look. I think one or two slight issues on the stream. Some lagged frames. Good here, says Bob. Strange. Possibly just Streamlabs slightly freaking out. We had to do an update just before I started, which is never ideal because I always want to do a couple of tests before we stream straight after doing an update. Right, it's by no means going to be perfect this first lap, but good as a bit of a reference. 2:18. Is the first lap. I think that was John there. Didn't quite see. Oh, no. No. 17 from Carlos. Well, I've just lost a big chunk of time there anyway, so we'll go again. Yeah, in the 19s already. 1.7 off the lead. Again, not a massive amount of tyre wear, so we should be okay. I'm trying not to have the same moment through Eau Rouge. I don't know if 6 years actually worth it there, or if we're best off actually just staying in fifth the whole time. Thank you. Yeah, I think always going to be worthwhile staying in fifth. One point one off the lead. Right, this is going to have to be our in lap now. Unless it just so happens to be so mega. Do too much on here as well. Oh shit, sorry guys, I was too busy trying to fix the stream there. Sorry, that's really not good, that, by me. Sorry guys, got in everyone's way there as well. I could have ruined somebody's lap. Sorry, not good from me, that. Right, but at least I think I've fixed the stream, the issues that we were having. What I should have done was just fix the stream in the pits, because now I'm going to be really pushing it to try and get the rest of this in lap and out lap. And then get across the line before it hits zero to get another push lap. Go on enough here for probably 2.5, close to 3 laps. Not going to have enough time here, am I? Nah, definitely not. Right, I'm only going to have enough time for one push lap, so a little bit of refueling. We refueled pretty quick actually there. The refuel rate was quite quick. Unless I do push here, I'm just trying to work out whether or not we would actually have enough time. We need to basically have 2 minutes 20 left when we cross the line. At this point here, well actually I'm not, because I haven't actually filled for enough fuel, have I? So let's take our time on this out lap and just try and make the first push lap count. DTR Cars, how are we doing? Welcome along. Hi, good luck, thank you very much. I might not have the best race, but overall, collectively, this will be a mega race from everyone. No doubt about that. Let's try and make this lap count. No pressure. That is not the quickest. Too many gears, what was I doing? What an idiot. Not even be an improvement in any of the sectors, I don't think. Still technically up on the. Oh no, I'm not. I'm 4/10 down. On sector 2, that was horrendous. Eddie, sorry, I mean Dave. P4 for us, everybody else is still running, they managed to get another lap, so. So, whilst everyone's doing that, I shall be back in a bit.
five.
So starting fifth. Unless Mike or Scott or Jonathan can improve their time. Oops, can improve their time on the last lap, yeah. Squeaking of this chair is doing my head in. Right, I'm going to start on the mediums. Just to give myself some options in the race, I think. Get those Punterinos. In the 16s, unbelievable. Tremendous pace that. I just hope they can't keep it up in the race. Right, we've got plenty of time now. Just trying to look at the for damage. As Scott was asking there. Right then. Well, thank you again to John for organising this lobby and running all that side of things. It's made things very, very run rather smoothly, which it never normally does when I'm trying to do this. I've just realised something. Layla,
what?
I've accidentally picked up your Huel and not mine.
What?
I've accidentally picked up your Huel and not mine. I haven't drank it though.
Oh, right.
Can you swap it, please?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry. Thank you. So 7:30, we're going to start the race. Scott saying wants the damage to be full. I might be inclined to agree with that, just because I'm guaranteed to bin it regardless and ruin my race. But if a few other people just hit the wall and then it totally messes up theirs as well, it might give me a bit more of a chance. But yeah, this is going to be fairly brutal. It's very warm in this room as well. So, I'm already absolutely boiling. Is Larry in chat at all or not? Or is he just on the just doing the race? I don't think I've seen him in the lobby yet. Thank you very much. Sorry, don't think I've seen him in chat. I think I said the lobby there. Eddie's saying, good luck, you mad lot. Eddie's just behind me here in P6. 3/10 behind. It's looking promising for Carlos. Although, to be fair, John's only within 1/10. 1/10 and 7/1000ths. Actually, that is a good question from Adam there. Do we actually start with quarter tank or not? Yeah. I'm not actually sure. Oh, full tank. Right, in that case. Oh, that might have just messed up my race altogether there. Someone saying settings are wrong. So I was going to be starting on the mediums, assuming. Assuming that we were starting with the 30 litres, but we're not, we're starting on full tanks. So I'm glad Adam double checked that one. Larry's good to go. I just need to double check if there's anything else that we need to have a look at and think about here. I don't think so. Ghosting off as well, that's one, definitely one thing to bear in mind. Right, I think we're all good. So I'll probably jump on to the mediums a little bit later in the race. It does just say, because James was saying that we need to run them for two laps, but required tyre type change medium. It doesn't say that you've got to run them for a minimum number of laps or anything like that. Either way, we're going to be running them for more than two laps, but we'll do a close to a full stint really on the mediums. Here we go. Right, we're starting. Already being told to give way to faster cars, that's never a good start, is it? Oh, the lights were on for a long time there. We got a good launch off the line though. Going for the same bit of road there. I almost got spun round right the way to the back of the grid. We drop. Larry might be struggling with connection there by the looks of things, which might have explained the slight moment we had at the start there. Scott's ran wide. They're all into each other there. Everyone into everyone. P4. This is where we just run for as fast as we can, for as long as we can. And just see how the tyres hold up and all that sort of stuff. Adam right in front of us. Hopefully the stream's all good. I do keep getting notifications from Streamlabs saying that we're dropping off a little bit, but I think we should be okay. Alright, it's going to be a very long race this. So we need quite a bit of patience. When I actually think about it, we're going to end up doing about 60 laps here, maybe, of Spa. Which is quite the challenge. In front of us, yeah. Oh, close. What's he in again, Adam? The Ferrari? I think that's why he's in there, isn't he? Said I was aiming for a podium, and we've got that podium spot at the moment. But an endurance race is mighty difficult. You basically have to, at all times, be watching the leader. They are the ones that set the pace of the race. It's not normally about the amount of laps completed. They could set the pace, the people in front can be running at half speed if everybody else does that behind them. They still win. Whether or not you take the gamble to try and push that little bit more, all the extra pit stops that you've got to think about, the extra pressure on the tyres. John in 60 seconds, how are we doing? Hope we're all well. Been a little while. Right, 5 seconds is the gap up front. I'm sweating already, we've not even done 10 minutes yet. This is going to be so brutal. Long time no see, absolutely. He has had him flying behind us, yeah. It's going to be a pretty boring race for Chaos if he stays out front. I thought we should make a bit of a mistake or something and bring us back in the running so early on in the race. Oh, John's gone wide there. It's going to put us right on the back of him. Bit of pressure. Probably try and work together with him here, to be fair. In that slipstream. Ooh, that was so close there. That was so close. Go, that's our chance. Nah, and we just ran straight in the back from there. I couldn't decide, literally could not decide which way to go. There's Adam pushing up behind us with a tremendous run. These two cars are very evenly matched. You see, like, we match pace in and out of the corners. Pretty much identical. This is Mega so far, just trying to sit behind him, really. Chance to just save a little bit on fuel, try and run perhaps that little bit longer. We've definitely got the life in the tyres to be able to do so. Could maybe look at like 20 lap stints even on the soft tyres here if we really wanted to. Longer stint on the mediums as well if we really wanted to, but that one I'm not too sure on. The deg is so low that I actually wonder whether or not we should just do one lap on the mediums, get straight back onto the soft tyres and just run it that way. Just clipped the wall there. This might be my chance now. This might be my chance. Scotty Senior behind us there. Look at this. Here he is. Here he comes flying through. Oh yes, John, that was absolutely unreal there, side by side. Oh, I didn't see Scotty there. Sorry, Scotty. Moved slightly. What may have seemed slightly late there. Just quite didn't spot him. We're all right on top of each other now. I'm going to run wide though. Brake too late. No, we're all good. Now he's probably going to go for a move to the inside here. I just want to try and keep my line though. Stay in fifth to try and defend it. Thought Larry would have gone for the move there. I just stayed to the left hand side. I was almost happy for him to go for it. Which is what I thought he was going to do. Larry with a 217.9 at the moment. That's a fastest lap. Right, I've pulled the gap down by about a second to Carlos. Oh, we set the fastest lap there now, 17.9. Wasn't expecting that. Gap down to 9 seconds now, 8.8. Wonder what's going on with Carlos up top there. Possibly just doing a bit more fuel saving. Concerned about at the moment, which is good. 8.1 now the gap. Just trying to settle in a little bit now, another fastest lap there, which is good. So I say it's probably got more to do with the fact that the last two laps I messed up turn one, so I might have had a much faster run down here because I actually ran too deep into the corner. Defend a bit there against Larry. Even though a couple of laps ago I was saying I was happy for him to get past. Confidence after setting a few fastest laps has got to my head. Now I'm starting to feel the car slide around a little bit and kind of lose grip, I think, on those tyres. Oh, a few new faces in the chat there, sorry guys, just spotted you. I'll try and catch your names in just a second. Does one of them say it? Roger, I could be totally wrong there. Roger, it certainly does. How are we doing, mate? Welcome along. Two streams, is somebody else streaming this as well? Oh, is Scotty streaming this by any chance, is he? I wonder if Scotty's streaming it as well. Larry's gone for it, he's opened the door there. Fair play. I don't want to battle with him too much here though. Oh, the internet connection's messing us up a little bit, isn't it? Come on, so we can keep pushing to Carlos here. Try and get back past Larry here if I can do. I Cheech, how are you doing? Sorry, mate, didn't see you in chat either. Apologies. I'm trying not to make contact with Larry here, but obviously it's a little bit tricky at the moment. He's driving at a 40 degree angle there, according to this. Makes it a bit tricky to judge. I'm hoping that if anything does happen, we can be forgiven. Looks like we might have ourselves the grey clouds there. A bit of rain on the way. So you're getting pretty dark now. Yeah, a bit of rain on the way for sure. I don't know why I'm acting surprised. We knew that there would be just a little bit at some point. Look at the speed difference here. If you see that there, the closing speeds of Scotty. That was ridiculous. Don't know what car he's in actually. Is he in the Toyota? Might explain it. Obviously got such a much better run as well through Eau Rouge and Radion. Come on, let's not start making these mistakes. Bit of rain on the way, I think, now. Now you can see it on the radar. He's gone slightly. Oh, he's had a bit of a moment there. That's going to allow us, hopefully, to get past. So John's gone in now on the mediums, which is interesting. I didn't realise he'd started on them. Into the pits there as well. Much lower on fuel than we are. This is where we need to start thinking about pit stops and stuff like that. So we got enough here to do finish this lap and one more, and then we have to box. So box and end of the next lap, which will be lap 18. I probably could have done a better job of fuel saving, really, if I thought about wanting to go further. That's so frustrating. Carlos into the pits. He's been on the medium tyres all that time, and I've not been able to catch up with him. All that time he's been on the worst set of tyres. How frustrating is that? Man. That's brutal. The fuel now. I'm going to fill up all the way full. Refuel's actually quite quick, so that's good. We might try and stretch this out. So we've got 18 laps there. We might try and stretch this out to maybe try and get 20, something like that. Gonna be about 10 seconds behind Carlos when all said and done there. And probably now he's done his stint on the mediums. We have not. Thank you. on that. This is the problem now, we've got so much field spread. Everybody on different strategies, really, really being able to think about which way they want to take the race. So we've got 6 seconds to the gap in front and 12 behind. Yet, when we finish this race, it will all be so, so close, I'm sure of it. This second stint could be quite important because we've got a little bit of weather to sort of battle through, which looks to be on its way. And the reason that I went for the softs again is I don't think it 100% guaranteed that we needed the intermediates for it. As we can see, that actually that first little bit of rain has gone. So not on the radar, not something that we need to think about. Thank you. God, this is a challenge. Just seen two cars up front there, but I don't know who they are. I don't know if one of them is Larry or not. I think one of them might be. No, we've got blue flags being shown, so maybe not. There we go, it's James in front here. Thank you, mate. Good stuff. Right, one third of the way through this absolutely epic event. Carlos at the moment. Doing quite a bit more to try and fuel save during this stint here. Might be a penalty. Right. Couldn't quite see exactly. I thought I might have just took just a little bit too much track. No, hit the wall, hit the wall, hit the wall. No, that's going to cost us time. Jack, how are we doing? It's going pretty well, mate. We're this P3 is genuine at the moment. This isn't going to change based on pit stops. Everyone's being in and kind of into their second stint at the moment now. We've got a bit of field spread, which I was just talking about a little bit before. Just saying, as everybody kind of just, you know, sort of fits into their strategies and the way that they're going to run the race. I'm trying to just fuel save a little bit on this stint, just in case we have what looks like a little bit of rain coming. Oh, talking before there as well about whether or not it's actually worth going on. We need to do a medium tyre stint, but whether or not it's actually worth just doing that for one lap, getting straight back in and just trying to make this set of super soft or racing soft make up for that time. Yellow flags on track. I think it's been clear though. Well, whoever's had a bit of a spin, I think this might be up ahead here. Yellow flags again. On the weather radar at the moment. Seem to be much quicker than Carlos through there, but that's the only corner where I am. Everywhere else I lose time. I think that's called no-name corner, is it not? After Ravage. And that is the only corner where I'm making up time. Thank you. Larry seems to be pulling away as well. We had a 6 second gap to him a while ago, and that's now up to 9 seconds, so slowly but surely he's pulling away. 3/4 tenths a lap. Right, John's into the pits on the softs there. So he pitted a little bit earlier. He went in on the, started on the mediums, pitted earlier, went in onto the softs, and he's been on them since. I think he maybe's pitted, what might he have pitted? Lap 12, 14, 15, 16, something like that. Well, we pitted lap 18, so he must have pitted maybe his lap 10. He's probably got about the same number of laps, I would have assumed. That's a mistake I don't want to make too often. Oh, we've almost made it again. Oh, and I've gone too deep. Come on. Making silly mistakes. Definitely less grip as we head into night time. 1 hour and 52 remaining, come on. Right, Scott into the pits, P8 there. Onto the medium, Scott goes. That's what we're going to have to do next. What we got left in the tank, yeah. 36%. About six laps remaining. Here comes what looks like a second stint of rain. Into the pits as well there, but he's got only 6% fuel. That Porsche is absolutely rinsing through the fuel, so he might end up having to do an extra pit stop to everybody else, or to me at least. I said I wanted the podium. P3 is what I'm aiming for here. And watch for DP though for John, because he's gone with a totally different strategy. Started on the mediums. I think he's the only one to do so. Carlos did as well, actually. Seems to be brightening up now, but I thought we were going totally through the night, but it didn't seem like it actually got that dark. Might be heading into it now. Seemed to just start brightening up there though. Right, frustratingly, Carlos literally has an entire pit stop gap now. 32 laps, 27 second gap. He's been just under a second quicker per lap, which is beyond frustrating. Wasn't predicting what James was going to do there. Oh man, what a numpty I am. Sorry, James. 29 seconds is the gap to Carlos. Look at that. That is just tragic. Absolutely tragic. Feeling like this entire stint has been absolutely awful. I've got nowhere near to fastest laps or anything like that. Not even set any personal bests, anything. So I do think we've lost just a little bit of grip, but it doesn't seem to be affecting Carlos annoyingly. Just keeping an eye on the weather radar there. Three off again. Right, keep an eye on this weather now, because this is what is going to make such a huge difference in this race. Could affect all our strategies now, to the point where I'm going to have to start really fuel saving here just to give myself some options, because otherwise I'd be due to pit in the next lap or so. But if I'm going to need to pit for Inters, I want to do it at the right time, so I need to give myself some options here. Worse than my profile, slow on the race line. Oh, I'll catch all that comment in just a second, mate. Unfortunately, I can't even read that. Oh, when Shui came up to lap him, yeah. People still question whether or not that was intentional, don't they? Come on, this is where it starts making a difference. No moisture on the track at the moment. Well, there is moisture on the track, sorry, but no puddles of standing water just yet. Right, Carlos goes into the pits now. What's he going to go onto though? This is a bit of a nightmare for him. So he doesn't know yet whether or not he should be onto the soft tyres still, or whether he should actually be thinking about the Inters. So it works out quite nicely for us that we can get a couple of more laps in here before we decide what to go on. And how frustrating is that? Look at that, Carlos still comes out in front of us. He's filled his car all the way up. I think he came out on the soft steady there, I presume. He's got to have. Pretty stupid to come out on anything else. Expect the rain to clean up for a little while. It doesn't look like we're going to have too much. Do have just that little bit of rain though. It's enough to make you really think about what you're doing. Just losing a little bit of grip on the track. Again, enough to make you think about what you're doing. Is it going to be enough to require Inters though? That is the question. Almost looks as if it's moving away from us now, so we should be okay. A few people might think about pitting. See if anybody goes into the pits behind us now. Got enough to try and stretch the fuel for two laps. Right, we can see there the weather sort of disappeared from us a little bit. Away it goes. I'm just going to try and eke out another lap here. Actually, no, I'm not, because that's just going to be silly. Right. Let's get our stint done on the mediums. The question is whether or not we actually just go for one lap and try and make up the time. I think I've got to see what the pace is like on the mediums here. I feel like I've got to do really realistically. I've got to do as long as I can go on the mediums, don't I? Go, 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 go. Let's do two laps here and make the judgment. Do we be really stupid? And come off the mediums really early to try and do an extra quicker stint on the softs and make up that time. It's a long pit stop though. You're looking at about 40, you're looking at about 25 seconds, I would say, in total lost, because then you have that pretty, you come out the pits a lot later on the straight down to Eau Rouge and Radion, so you lose a lot of time there as well. Performance difference though is pretty Eighty-one laps, you reckon, Brian? Is that what you, how many laps do you think we're going to end up doing? I suppose if you look at it now, we're halfway through now, almost. We'll have done 38, 39 laps. Yeah, you're probably not. Yeah, maybe about 80 laps. I don't think you're too far off there at all. Really not a fan of these tyres. Well, let's try and work it out here now, because we've done 18 laps and then 18 again. And let's presume that we're doing 80. We've got 42 laps to go, 18 and 18 again. I'm probably going to do, right, okay, I figured it out. So I'm probably going to do about 8 laps on the medium, something like that. Not a huge amount. And then just split the remaining amount of laps. Basically, I'm going to go to about lap 46. On the mediums. Don't know if that really works out very well, but yeah, 79 is what we're maybe thinking. Basically see what the lap times look like on the mediums. Because it might be worth trying to get to about lap 50 to about lap 60, so 22 laps, 23 laps on these. Is that going to be worth doing? It probably is, because are we realistically going to take a second a lap, be a second a lap quicker every single lap? Or 1.2, 1.3 seconds a lap, every single lap quicker on the soft tyres. That's what we would have to be. Is it actually going to be worth it? The looks of it at the moment, probably yes. 7 to 8 on the mediums, Brian says. Do you agree with me, Brian, do you reckon? Because, I mean, we've set some bad lap times on the softs as well. 220s there, 219, 221 as well. You set a 220.7. I just don't know if we're actually going to have the extra pace or whether or not it's worth just avoiding the pit stop and doing... just trying to work it out, because I've also then got a fuel save also. I think it's going to be about the same, and I think I would probably rather be racing about on the soft tyres and pushing a little bit harder on them. See what times you do, yeah, exactly. So I don't know if I managed to explain my thought process very well, but yeah, I mean, look at that, 2.1 seconds. And we're going to have to be going even slower again, because... so say that we're 20, even if you say 30 second pit stop, 15 laps on these mediums, is going to cost us that pit stop. Oh. Let's just get off these as soon as we can. In fact, let's just get off them this lap. Let's just get off them. Heavy rain next time, may need the wets. Well, that's also the problem. Then I'm thinking, do we hang fire here and just stay on these tyres? Because if we're going to have to change pit stops for another tyre change, then that's going to mess us right up, isn't it? So it's a weird one. It's a weird one, and we've got Adam now absolutely flying up behind us. I'm not sure what tyre Adam's on now, or whereabouts in his race he is. Stint wise. Is the stream all good, Brian, by the way? Because I keep getting notifications from Streamlabs saying it's lagging and it's going all horribly wrong, but it seems to be okay. Is everything, is it looking all right and everything? Yeah, stay on these and wait for the rain, Stu says. How are we doing, by the way, Stu? Hope we're all well. Adam's right behind us. Adam's going to be looking for the move. I don't know if he knows that we're on the mediums. Fair, if Adam wanted to get past us now, I probably wouldn't be too against it. So one key bit of information that we should have on the lap times there is actually an average lap time That would be very, very helpful to know kind of what our average lap time was on the soft tyres. Because it's all well and good, it's referencing every time that it's saying plus 2 seconds, plus 3 seconds, that is referencing our fastest lap, which was a 2:17. That's not much use. So wait for the rain to come, I think, is the decision here. On the mediums. Safe to say I'll know Spa pretty well after this. Oh, Brian says all good as well, that's good to know then. Panic over. Rain could be 30 minutes away, that's it, but keep running on these for now. Lap times on the mediums probably isn't the absolute worst, to be honest. Staying on them probably is a better idea than trying to pit and then make the time back up. Just running the risk trying to push too hard that way as well, aren't you? So but just trying to save fuel as much as possible. Starting to coast into a few of these corners and things like that as well. comes right on us now. That Adam's on the soft tyres, but I think that he might actually be on the mediums, the same as us, for some reason. That's what I'm thinking. An hour and 20 left to go. Carlos all the way out front by a minute now, which is just sickening. But fair play to him. Oh, almost lost it. Almost lost it there. Whew. Now we're starting to get there with these mediums, actually. Yeah, I'll have predicted the rain note that he's just pitted. Yeah, absolutely. I did spot that. Just yet on the radar there, 1.5 off the my current fastest lap, which probably isn't too bad on the mediums. Yeah, it came back on 100% fuel and racing soft. Yeah, okie dokie. Right, Adam's looking for the move this time round. Yeah. Gets it done, nicely done. Steady. Right, Right, Larry into the pits there as well on the soft tyres. So he comes back out on. So we've held Adam up for a little bit and now he's absolutely flying ahead of us. This is starting to be a little bit brutal now. Watching Adam fly forward through the race. And I'm now trying to sit tight and just stretch out these mediums for when this rain supposedly comes. Oh, Adam's got a penalty. Adam must be on the soft tyres, yeah, gotta be. all on Racing Soft, good stuff. Right, okay, that's fine. I don't know if Adam's been into the pits yet and done his stint on the medium, so that's also a part of the problem. So annoying about Carlos, though, just absolutely flying up the road. Just over an hour left. Okay, Layla. Yeah. Yeah, it's boiling in here, I know. Yeah, I've got the window open, yeah. Almost ran wide there, that was lucky. And 60, yeah, just a hunch, right? And we'll go with your hunch, Brian, and we'll stick with that. I'm quite happy lapping on these mediums at the moment. The same stint that we've just done there. I mean, what we done now? 13 laps on them now. Probably go do that stint again. I'd be more than happy. So, I reckon. I wonder if I could actually get away with going for at least another 10 laps on these. The only thing that's going to stop me doing that actually is fuel. Oh, someone's gone. It's James. Thank you. many more laps do we think we can do? 6 more laps, this is the only problem. Maybe lap 56. And how many laps is that? To 80. 24 laps. I think if I really tried, I could get 24 laps out of a set of soft tyres, but that's just... Tyres would be fine, it's just fuel that would be the issue. I'm just going to have to really focus on saving fuel now. See if we can make this fuel last a few extra laps. Right, Carlos into the pits now. This is interesting. This is where it gets interesting. Shut your door just for the noise there. Thank you. Oh, 2.7, losing too much time now though. Having to do all this fuel saving. Tough now. But I make the medium tyres last till whenever the rain comes, then ideal. Problem being is we don't know when the rain's going to come. Although, there it is on the radar there now. So let's see where it is in three, maybe hopefully four laps time. What's that about, Scotty? Oh, tremendous. I thought that said Scotty's streaming, but barely speaking any. Oh, well, that's funny. At least we don't have to worry about them then. Right, now we're talking though, the weather's starting to come in. Having to do a lot of lift and coast here just to try and save the fuel and make sure we can just stay on these tyres this whole stint. Does that say I look beat or I look best? Can't tell whether that's an S or an A. Beat. Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. Messed up the strategy slightly. Now having to be on the medium tyres for a little bit longer, but just trying to hold out in the hope that some rain comes. Really trying to save as much fuel as possible here. Just gonna have to come in, I think. Now should have gone for my initial strategy, I think. Really just trying to stretch the fuel now and make this play out, because we can see the rain is coming. So we know what tyres we need to be on when it lands. Just trying to time this right now. Stretch and eke out this fuel as much as we can do. Just look at that, losing like half a tenth, literally. Constantly. Every half second, I'm losing half a second. Half a tenth, rather. One 1.6 slower this first sector. 1.6 down on this lap already. It's going to take another lap or so before the rain gets here. But when it lands, thank you. trying to make this fuel last. My God, I'm trying to make this fuel last. Whilst trying not to lose an ungodly amount of time. I've just got to commit to it now. This is the problem. Oh, look at that. Adam's pitted now. Adam's pitted at the perfect time here. Adam's pitted at the perfect time. He knows it's worth a gamble probably to go on to wet tyres as well, I think. I think he'll do it. What's he going to do? What's he going to do? 5 seconds slower per lap now. We definitely should have just came in earlier, went on to the softs. Look at that, there you go. Adam's not even filled up full fuel, he's just gone 40% because he knows he's going to be straight back in soon. This weather, this bad weather can't come quick enough yet for me. Adam's going to come up flying behind us as well here now. Basically need to try and time it so that end of the next lap I'm onto the full wets. Or do we go in as I think full wets, it's got to be full wets. I've just got to make this fuel last for one more lap. There's Adam there. Someone's gone into the pits. I'm sure there, I've just saw someone in. Either way, Adam's getting past me here, so Scotty into the pits, he's timed that wonderfully there. Carlos into the pits as well, also timing it wonderfully. What's Carlos going to come out on here? It's got to be, surely, the wet tyres. It's worth the gamble, surely. Are going to come out on. He has the rate. Yeah, he's done it. He's done it. He's gone in on the wet tyres. Perfectly. Perfectly timed. Us, not so much. I don't have the wet tyres. I don't even have the wet tyres. What an idiot. What an idiot. Moron. Oh, man. What an absolute idiot. Devastated. Absolutely devastated. That's the race done now. That is the race done now. Well, that's us out of this race then. Git. Literally about to get lapped by Carlos. Done for, exactly. That is proper gutting that. That's literally all I can do is just crawl around like this now. Oh, what a waste. Really? Yeah, James is the same. No wet tires. To get lapped by Carlos for the second time now. That we can't even turn. Yeah, we're done. We're done. And there we go. That's all of the positions now lost. And again. Only hope that I've got. I literally can't like do anything here. The only hope that I've got is that it dries very quickly. That's Adam lapping me now as well. Literally going to be getting lapped by everybody on the grid. It's like this dry line starting to appear. Already. You've just got to stay on that dry line though. Just can't run wide at all though. Might as well spin. I really don't think that this minute penalty, 1 second penalty is going to make too much difference, is it? Yeah, I'm still going wide. Fantastic. Yeah. I don't think I can do 30 minutes, another 30 minutes of this. Carlos has gone a lap for the second time. Literally two laps down on this race now. Yeah, dry line's pretty much there, the whole track. You just need to not drop off of it though, that's the problem. As we see, we're matching Carlos now. Oh, there's a little pit again, yeah, I think so. Took one little mistake like that on a daily race a few weeks ago as well. Scott's onto the, literally I can't do another 30 minutes of this. Scott's onto the racing tyres now, I think. He's coming off the wet tyres. Softs. Brian says. Swear, you need to be careful. You see how quick we're catching to Scott though. I think he's had a bit of an off there. Actually, no, that was Eddie that was originally in that place, not Scott. I think Eddie's dropped out, has he? No, he hasn't. What's happened to Scott then? Scott came out on the soft tyres. Oh, maybe he's just done what I've done there.
So sorry. So sorry, Scotty. I think that was Scotty.
So sorry, mate. Totally binned it there. Tried to get out his way, put myself up onto the curb, and then binned it. Exactly, James. Horrendous, this, isn't it? Absolutely aced by Carlos this race, by the way. Should kick them from the lobby. No, that was my fault. Are you talking about Scotty? That was my fault, that one. Unless I missed something. I probably missed something. Well, I'm gutted that I didn't have the tyres, because otherwise that might have actually worked out all right for us, but that is just such a stupid schoolboy error, that one. Thank you. hooligans on this track. They've still done better than me, that's the mad thing. They're absolutely mortal drunk, and yet Scotty and Craig still done better than me. Might be getting past Eddie here. Might at least catch up to him. Has Carlos came in yet, or is he still on the, is he still on the wet tyres? Done it again. What would a lap of Spa be without a 720 spin? Good fun. It wasn't until I had that awful pit stop. Here's Eddie, let's try and have a good race with Eddie. Just moved himself over onto the wet stuff there, didn't he? Carlos has lapped us twice, he's going into the pits now, he's still going to come out in front of us. Guarantee it. Thank you. he does technically come out behind us. So we've now unlapped ourselves by one lap. He's still lapped us twice. He's still lapped us once. And he'll be lapping us very soon for the second time again. So we'll be back to being two laps down. Boss on the radio reckons you can reach Scotty, hopefully. Steve. Yeah, come on then, P6, let's see if we can have it. So and there's Carlos lapping us again. I was trying to read Craig's comment there. Scotty's having technical problems. Good. Good. Let's see if we can catch him. Scotty's waiting for us down the race. That's right, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Battle of the YouTubers at the end. I think we know who's going to win it regardless, so let's do our best though, eh? Here he is. Scotty's way quicker than me though, so this isn't going to last very long. Move. conscious of fuel now. Send. Let's do it. Chat limits. Thank you. good racing with Scotty. The highlight of the stream after it all went wrong. Have, I think, two more laps left here. Yeah. Although I'm not too sure because Carlos is two laps ahead, so. That's it, send it to Scotty or he'd be disappointed. Come on. This could end up being, I think this will be the last lap. It just depends on when Carlos crosses the line. He's been like 5 minutes ahead, so. Thank you. Nice send. There we are, final lap. Supra will have us though on the straights. We've got enough fuel to just be able to push through the gears. It's absolutely going to have us on the straights though, watch. This could be the send of all sends. Fair play, Scotty, mate. Good racing. Good racing. What a treat. Oh, man. That was a fairly brutal 3 hours, that. Made worse by the fact we didn't have either of the wet tyres on the pit stop. I think we could have genuinely been looking at the podium. Oh man, what a brilliant race though, brilliant event. Huge thank you to everybody for tuning in, for attending. Carlos's time, look at that, 3 hours and 34 minutes. Man, that was good. Enjoy the last 25 minutes. Yeah, exactly. Same here. That was brutal. There we go, though. Right, I hope everyone's enjoyed it. I'm going to head straight off. So we've got an early start tomorrow as well. But I really hope everybody's enjoyed it. Thank you so much for tuning in. We've been racing tonight for the British Heart Foundation. Links in the description to find out more, to share and to donate. If you haven't done so already, please do hit the like button on the stream. And if you also haven't done so, please do subscribe as well to the channel. Helps massively. It really, really does. Hope everybody's enjoyed it. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you to everybody on the grid for racing. We shall put another one of these on at some point, I'm sure. And I will be looking forward to that, and I'm looking forward to seeing everybody again. We'll be back on Monday for our usual Monday night stream, looking at the daily races. Craig's already sent me them through. I can't remember what they were off the top of my head. What were they? What's the new track? Highway something. What's it called? The big tall one with the big bridge. The new track. So I look forward to that one. That'll be next week's daily race. But there we go. Appreciate it. Thanking you very much. Good night, everybody. Enjoy your weekend. And I shall see you all on Monday. Toodles.